This was it. I had no idea what to expect. It was these few moments in which all my anticipation was up. Looking through the window, I couldn't help but have tears fall down my face. I've been waiting for this moment, not just for the semester, not just for the year, but for years, since I was younger. It was finally happening. The culture, the food, the people. I had so many ideas, so many plans, just everything was building up in me, and it was overwhelming, and it came to the point where all my thoughts were hitting me all at once. Not the many hours we were traveling in the plane, but this moment when we were landing, is when all these thoughts hit me, and when it seemed like this was my only moment, this was my defining moment. And I had to do all that I could do to get the most out of it. And I was going to. Being that we were a week in, I wasn't really getting the experience and building up on anticipation like I was upon arriving. I allowed several negative aspects to the trip to dictate my overall experience, and it was killing me. And I shouldn't have done that. And in lieu of all these feelings and frustration, one day while I'm walking to class, I get hit by what you're looking at right now. This paper airplane came out of nowhere, and I had no idea where it was coming from, and I had to take another picture right here. And here is a picture of the window that it came from, but what you'll see is missing is the person that threw it. But as silly as it sounds, the airplane hitting me gave me a thought that if I didn't try and make everything negative that I felt was negative positive, I was never going to get what I wanted out of the trip. It also took some guidance from Issa to reiterate the same thing to me, but there were small things that happened to me that made me realize that I can't allow one or two few things to taint my experience. So from here on out, I really tried to get it together. In efforts to be positive, I looked up the sister church to my church in Massachusetts. And lucky for me, there was a one that was in Milano. So I was really excited. I was gonna hop on the train at St. Ambrogio, which is the Green Line, and take it all the way to Lambrate, which is also the Green Line, and walk from Lambrate to this lovely congregation. Now, in efforts to get there on time, I made sure I looked up on Google Images and Google Maps to make sure that I got to the right place. When I did that, this is the image that I found. Despite this image, I was still very optimistic, and I said, you know what? I'm still gonna go. So, I went. You must be wondering where I'm going on this train. Given my track record of luck, you can imagine that I went to that location and there, in fact, was no church. So, given those odds, I didn't dwell on it. I thought very quickly, and I remembered. While I was at the train station, somebody had said that IKEA, or as Italians say, IKEA, is not too far away from where I was at Lambrate. It's one of my favorite stores. Couldn't pass this opportunity up, so I decided to go. And I coined a new saying, which is also the subtitle to this presentation, which is learning to take lemons and make gelato.